wanted to take the refuge in the Buddha Dhamma Sangha, one has to have the cultivate of enough understanding wisdom. Why? What reason? Should be enough reason in order to become stone taking refuge. Taking refuge is all purpose for the to produce more happiness and peace. So one must know what is the situation of the most one reality, and then one can see worthwhile. Otherwise, all taking refuge could be the accusation of the miserable or dissatisfaction. Why? The reason is we do take refuge in the object of the sense pleasure. We talk already, taking refuge already. That's why taking refuge is to do with attitude. When we take refuge, means we change the attitude, refuge on the sense pleasure or the materialistic attitude. The change to the into the taking refuge to Dhamma wisdom. Now, to change this attitude, we have to gain some kind of wisdom, which is the recognize all the misconception. The holding miserable situation or reactionary confusion situation that we holding as pleasure. we have more strength. Or confidence. Invisible, you know, the sense invisible, the reality of God. For example, Nagarjuna. Infection, that disease, you know. What disease you call the infection disease? When you scratch? Itching, you know. Well, no, yeah, it is itching, sorry. When you scratch it, you peel, this something, yeah. English, I don't know that name. Then we get pleasure. This is the wrong conception, you know. Wrong conception, they're thinking this is the getting pleasure. Understand? The same thing. This is the perfect good example, you know. We holding that kind of sense of pleasure, okay? This kind of sense of pleasure is the happy, you know? Another way of saying, the pain release is that they think happy, you know? Pain release. Maybe this is burning with fire. Suddenly the fire gone out. Now happy. It's the wrong conception. Pain is still there. Understand? Conception, they're holding or suffering situation is the pleasure, and also the impermanent transitory situation is holding permanent, you know, or permanent existence. All these have to be at least one has to be intellectually clear and convene in order to take the refuge in wisdom, life. As you see, we are so busy 24 hours. By just thinking. Only this life package concerning how to do, what 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 to do. How to get pleasure. So extreme, this extreme, you know, attitude. Concerning this life, you know, how could be, you know, getting most pleasure. This tremendous, you know, energy is the fire to burn competence of the inner wisdom. So the fundamental, maybe fundamental, the all mindfulness of the Advaita Dhamma is important in order one begin to take level. Worldly phenomena, is Nagarjuna explains eight worldly phenomena. Oh, I think, do I need to mention or no? Maybe better. Oh. I thought you could mention it now. So actually, I'm not sure. It's like, one get much, you know, material thing, present, you know, Christmas present, one happy. One not getting, one get less unhappy, right? Oh, then one get, you know, reputation, sort of one happy. One get bad reputation, or not getting, you know, sweet reputation, one is unhappy. Then what? Yeah? I think the one. Thank you, donation. You can see we are taking a refuge as according outwardly, you know, phenomenon. You can see, you know, with the one experience. Say, as long this outwardly dharma, outwardly phenomenon is dancing, you know, dancing, and thinking, this thing. Taking refuge is like blooming, no? Like the rubber bloom you send in the air, you know, sometimes disappear. Or, for example, somebody is telling you bad thing. You so worried. Almost, you know, beat, you know. Somebody says bad thing, a bad reputation. You so worried. Almost like, you know, almost like beat by the, you know, sticks, you know. That's sure. You incurable. Grasping. On the you hang up on the reputation pleasure, so that somebody says bad things to you, you just... Also, matter of fact, lack of wisdom. The understanding of the evolution of the how the ego trip is coming, you know. Tormentous developed the all grasping on the sense pleasure. Same thing as this one, as this one. Remember? Also, one understand once one, you know, the false view. Then one begin comes control, and also one begin comes integration, the penetration, concentration. Because at worldly characteristic is the destruction. So we always destruct. So the releasing all the tremendous ambition to gaining, you know, the tough stories, worldly pleasure. Reputation itself is not problem. Reputation comes from other people. Matter of fact, it comes from other sentient being. Good reputation, in other words, good reputation itself is not problem. Anyway, it comes from other people. You know, other people talk. So you get maybe good reputation. But problem is, you accept it. You hang up, you just obsess it with that reputation, with preconception, ego. That is the problem. World reputation, pleasure, is the manipulate you into the trap of suffocate. So it is a trick. It is a complete trick. You know, it's a kind of complete trick. You feel fantastic. You know, you see only good aspect, but this good aspect is the, you know, throat. Okay, to hook you into the trap. Or, therefore, to up and down those ridiculous, you know, the penetrative view is important. Small mind, you know, small, narrow mind, you know, called it such a small pleasure, thinking big, you know, comes to this situation. It's like phonetic, you know, phonetic mind.
Oh, to abhorring, to abandon. To smash. Manipulation of this, repeated this channel, this way, this way, this way, this way, this way, repeat. Not yet. Repeated. The pulse to react you this way, this way, this way, this way, this way. Pulse you react to you, repeated like this. No freedom. Because you are not sure. You're just running. You come here, you go like this. You go, you come in here, you go like this. You go there, you go like this. So you have no freedom. Even if you think your ego is so big, you know, I'm free. Doesn't matter how much you're proud, you are not free. That you can see with your own experience that sometimes you don't know why you're doing. Oh, you don't know. Almost you have no intention, you have no plan, but you're just doing. Oh, that is the situation. Therefore, I say, the fundamental mindfulness of Edwardian phenomenon is important, very important, to enter the to spiritual enlightenment. Yeah, for example, maybe a good example, in the West, West we do have religion. Now religion is degenerating, sort of, you know, coming, you know. Proportion of the majority of people, almost non-religion, you know. The reason is, the explosion of the grasping on the temporal pleasure, world phenomenon. This is the logical scientific evidence to be degenerate and not competent. You know, the inequality of human beings. Sense object tantalize is so successful. Tantalize, sense object. To tantalize to you how it's beautiful, how you look at this one, this is you look this one this way, look this way, this way. So you going like this, you know? Oh yeah, oh yeah. You understand? So this is successful. So inside is down, down, down. So this is the brainwashing.
This is the bad
that reason, many the Tibetan meditators, or they left their home and went to mountain. The reason is, understand? That's why Milarepa, he left his home and went in the mountain. That's all. Partisanship, dualistic mind, partisanship. I'm this, I'm white, you are black, okay? I'm red, you are east, I'm this family, you are that. Anything, any object you use for the developing more musical. Anything, almost anything what we see, our ego use, resource use, this use, everything to use, ego, the resource, energy, every resource, energy. It's the instinctive dualistic ego's nature. Nothing to do with the religion, nothing to do with the philosophy. Just instinctive characteristic of the, you know, ego's nature. Use any kind. So you can see. So, to avoid partisanship, this is the dualistic mind. This is the participant. I'm this, you are this, this. This is the responsible dualistic mind. However, as long we have extreme hungry for the pleasure of the sentimental sense pleasure, then taking refuge, the wisdom light becomes weak. This strong attitude, pleasure, temporal pleasure, lead you automatically, lead you into the miserable situation. Attitude, or the liberation, or enlightenment. By recognizing complex situation of egotistic mind, this attitude itself lead you peace to peace to enlightenment. All Dharma practitioners, the reason why their practice is become weak, sense of gravitation, the attitude, is sort of overwhelming, sort of difficult, sort of becomes weak. It may be this way. So simple example. We are each other fighting in the world. Big nation and a couple, boyfriend, girlfriend, they're fighting each other. And what do you think? Only you're not getting pleasure. Something to give you pleasure. That's what I find. Or split the marriage couple is not the deliberate, not the deliberate reason. Reason why each other, you know, not satisfied, not getting pleasure. You know, so the pleasure is the so important thing. So now, number one in your life, the attitude, number one is pleasure, sense pleasure. Oh, maybe number two or three is maybe I have some feeling to Dharma or liberation. maybe that is the only, maybe some kind of situation comes, happen. Sometimes, you know, situation not comes, also they don't disappear. tell you refuge in the Dharma wisdom is in our life. Very, very important. It is like antidote to the ego conflicting with the outwardly, you know, from. You're taking refuge in Dharma wisdom. Any problem come, we are living condition of to come problem. We open ten directions to come problem. Through each pore of the body. Problem come. We know, but with the Dharma wisdom, you can overcome the situation. This is the beauty of immediate reaction in Dharma. Or for example, my own experience, when I left Tibet 25 years old, I left my nest, my trap. Tibet is my trap, my samsara nest. Not the, because Dharma I left, because Mao, you know. poor Mao, great kindness, poor Mao, kick out, you know. At that time, 25 years boy, you know, didn't export such, you know, situation like India, you know. I think you know. Completely new world. They are human being, but almost alone that time, sort of, you know. You are alone. Your father, mother, uncle, sister, teacher, everybody left. So, that time, only who helped is the some situation. Dharma make to cope my life. Otherwise, incredible situation. Because all the pleasure is left. I mean, you know, normally you consider a pleasure. So all pleasure is left, and I'm out. So that's the best lesson for me, you know. I have my life. Oh, that shows that how much, you know, you have beauty, or how much you have handsome, or how much you have wealthy, or how much you have, you know, mature. When the time dead, even if we have to left out this body, have to go, only conscious, have to go. So the only at that time, help wisdom lie. No wisdom lie, then going into darkness. With the Dharma understanding, you can free from the any fear situation. Besides life and death, you know, any situation. Now, could be, you know, all free and transforming the music. difficult situation into pleasure. That is the beauty of, you know, all wisdom. Has a skill to cope any situation, somehow, to cope miserable situation. Or for example, let's say, you know, you put somebody to practice very hard into the, you know, miserable situation. Somebody is put, you know, doesn't have any, you know, understanding, you know, inequality. If you put two people into this situation, one becomes a banana, one becomes, you know, maybe apple, you know? Materialistic attitude has very little sort of, you know, quality of human being. Human being is not important. Tulip is more important. Tulip is more, you know, powerful because you export many maybe dollars. You know. The person who take refuge in them, he developed encouragement in himself, and he can see that one can solve what's one problem. Practice of Dhamma, one can see. Now, concerning what is Dharma, now, the question is, what is Dharma? The Dharma is comprehension, the wisdom, the understanding. All the reality. That is the Dharma. The function of Dharma to eliminate all confusion and dissatisfaction and preconception, the idea of ego. So, the real Dharma is not book, you know, or not the word. The real Dharma is the part of consciousness, part of mind and wisdom. Nothing to do with the temple, nothing to do with the image, nothing to do with the brain, maybe. I think his scientific mind is shock. Comforted. And also not just the word, intellectual, you know. Say, I have competent Dharma, life, not like that. You know, not just word. It's a truth experience. Small conflict comes, you use your wisdom Dharma, soft problem. The one small experiment, then you can, each time you stop your problem, you develop comfort. Don't try something unimaginable experience is the, you know, Dharma experience. You know. You understand? Expecting something space out. You know, that is the, understand? You know, the simplicity is from the gross level, the problem, by using Dharma wisdom, one stop, then one, you know, build up such a feeling, can really become taking refuge. Where to liberate or save you from the confusion, dissatisfaction by Buddha Dharma is not Buddha Dharma said, I take my compassion to you. Come to put it into your ear. You know? Not the his compassion taking to put it into your, you know, stomach. You know? Not that way. Your compassion, your wisdom, it becomes developed. Which is already existent fundamental now. talk about, remember, we talk about it, Buddha here saying, you know, the universal compassion and love quality, remember? Ah, Buddha here said, you know, the omnipresent, you know, wisdom, total impersonal, the universal wisdom. Ah, then, ah, the universal power, the force of power, wisdom, the power. So this is the, remember, the quality of, you know, Buddha, we talk about. Oh, no, these three, the quality is, the seed of quality is existent fundamentally. Now, each of us, we cannot say, I have no love, I have no compassion at all. I have no comprehension at all. I have no power at all. Therefore, I'm worthless. One should never think that. One put down oneself. We do have these three qualities. Matter is through Buddha's teaching or through your meditation to fertilize. To fertilize, you know, most of, you know, organic develop and powerful and it becomes possible. Oh, so that when we take refuge, we develop the, you know, confidence that once one develops the mental or compassion in the law, is certainty, you know, not harm. Any other being. And by development of wisdom, the eliminate all the, you know, all false, you know, projection and the ignorant projection. That way to, you know, or take the refuge. And also, when we take refuge, we recognize that Shakyamuni Buddha is, present Buddha is the, our Guru. Showing for noble truth, showing totality of our own reality. So we recognize as our Guru. You know, perfect leader to lead us into the totality, the enlightenment. And then the main thing, menu to take up the into enlightenment, this elevator is the Dhamma. So when we take refuge, we don't take refuge, Dhamma is somewhere space. You know, the Lord is somewhere space. Understand? You become light. Eliminate one darkness in the ego. So that your prayer book is not Dharma. Then Sangha. Oh, we do need a Sangha. Because we are not enough developed strength without influence of environment and the living being. Because, in other words, we are not free from the dualistic, notion. So by helping dualistic notion, we can reach to beyond the dualistic mind. Now, who is the Sangha? Who isn't Sangha? Sangha, the real, absolute Sangha, is one who fully developed the non-duality wisdom. You know, it's like first stage of Bodhisattva Bhumi. That is the most professional Sangha. The unprofessional Sangha sometimes help a little bit. Sometimes it produce more confusion. You know? That also Sangha. I mean, some extent it has Sangha meaning. But I guess, we have to go through this. That depend individual need. If you are the quality of Dharma practice is the indestructible nature, then you don't need the Sangha. If the practice is like yo-yo, up and down, we do need that. Individual experience. Especially when we say taking reference, I just talk about some kind of level, one level I talk about. Taking refuge can be from beginning part to enlightenment. So the deepest state of realization, deepest state of mind. So each of us, we take reference according individual, the need. For example, is the first state of Bodhisattva Bhumi, where they take reference is different than second stage of Bodhisattva Bhumi, Second Bodhisattva don't need take refuge at this, first stage of Bodhisattva Bhumi. So the 10th state of Bodhisattva Bhumi has, way of taking refuge different. So taking refuge is very profound. Actually, from beginning, part to enlightenment, up to end enlightenment, contain that, state of consciousness into the taking refuge. All state of the confidence, state of confidence,
can. Ah, elevate most highest, you know, destination and eliminate, you know, the worldly problem of egotistic problem. If one can, you know, have competence and memory, continued memory, then one always takes them. Non-stopping you take refuge. Or taking refuge, you don't need to read a book. You can go beyond book or paper. And taking refuge, you don't need to go temple. You can take refuge in bathroom. That's the best way. Less dualistic, fleshy. Could be taking refuge can could be, you know, if you have that kind of mind, 24 hours, you know, 24 hours, you have that memory, 24 hours, you take refuge. You are lie down sleeping. Still, if you have that strong, you know, the memory of this, you know, you take refuge even if you're sleeping. For example, many people have experienced that when they have a dream, horrible dream, while they're sleeping, in the dream, they're taking refuge in the Dharma wisdom, and in the sort of problem, even in the dream. Taking refuge, objective is need profoundly we cannot take refuge like this tulip. I ask him taking refuge this tulip. Please, you know, release, please tulip, please release my dissatisfaction. Please release my ego. Please release, you know, you understand, my dualistic mind. You can't. Tulip is not worthwhile object of taking refuge, which is we. Our problem is bigger, you know, too big. Tulip cannot solve the problem. Thank you. taking refuge objective should be, ah, sort of, you know, beyond limitation of the quality. Taking refuge in the sun and the moon and the stars and hungry ghosts, those things, not worthwhile, because cannot solve problem. Because our problem is limitation. So the limitation, the object, cannot lead, as the beyond the limitation. And also when we take refuge, there is the benefit. Always the insight, encourage, and you can do something. Doesn't matter what situation, you can do something. It means it's allowing, the intelligence is functioning. So there's no way, actually, it won't take refuge. No way one destroy oneself, like one kill oneself. Those are, one don't understand. What's one? The nuclear light energy. So the one is respectful, and the one thinking, this life is the pressure. So the use as much as possible, most beneficial way. We use always like garbage bag, garbage bag. Contaminated bag. Our life we use, garbage we throw, all these things throw in inside. So we use our life that way, and that makes it difficult. Conscious energy is much more bigger than this physical, energy. And much more profound than this physical energy. Also, our physical emanation is also the energy is manifest from the conscious. Okay, now I think better we pretty soon stop. Isn't it? Okay, now. Now the situation was one lifestyle, life. What kind of was one life and dealing with problem and recognizing repeatedly in habitual this thing. If one not stop this repeated reaction, it's almost endless. We are reacting life to life. It's important to know. You can see this life how to react to you, continuously without stopping. So this understanding is the enough when you die. All this garbage built up energy must be to react again. So the endless sort of, looks like endless. You see, how this, confusion is reacting. Again. This is not only me. also many living beings having that kind of situation. So the end up with a miserable situation and much compassion. The Mahayana way taking refuge, not only, you know, you sort of, you know, concern yourself. First, of course, concern your situation, how the, you know, all the negativity, you know, ego, the energy, they develop. Then can see also, you know, not only me, many living beings also problem. So then, okay, with great compassion, you know, from the taking refuge, compassion. That way, taking refuge is more broad, you know, rather than me. You know. Me again, you know, all things again, you know, all true, you know. Concerning me is the old trip, not new thing. Okay, now, that's why you're going to have meditation, do you? You're going. Okay, so the meditation, breathing, and then contemplate from the breathing to mindfulness of the mind, you contemplate on the conscious, contemplate. And the reason is that reactionary, this rolling, you know, with the uncontrolled rolling, this have to stop. Making conversation, you know, conversation, non-stopping conversation, you know, you understand? This is our problem. You know, we have to learn how to stop the reactionary or the dualistic, you know, irritated, you know, the mind. We have to stop. Yes. So the way to stop it, not the problem. Buddha's way to stop this one, you don't need with a knife. You understand? With a peaceful, with a compassion. And let go as it is, and touch in nature by let going, rather than putting tremendous flavor, 100, you know, 100 flavor of ice cream, you know, so your tongue is confused already now. When reactionary, you know, when stopped in reactionary concept, your conscious becomes clean, clear, ocean. So they can take reflection of universal, the reality reflection can take into that. Any thought come, even negative thought come, instead of making conversation, say, did that, making sort of, you know, rolling with it, you know, negative mind, you know, just open eye, wisdom. So our mindfulness open like this. Just watching.
Also see.
It's naturally clear.
Don't cut yourself. Don't take help.
I'm not sure what I'm saying. Do you understand or no? Wait a minute, I'm saying, look at this way. I say it, when this negative mind comes, instead of what karma, what form, how nice, you know, normalization could be making compensation. Legal mind come. Watching. The essence of watching to essence of negative mind. Then it will disappear into clarity. That way to stop. That way to stop naked mind.
It's also positive.
The essence of even polluted mind is has got clear nature. And it's enough when you meditate on the conscious. Just enough. Just aware. Your mind is mindful. Just enough. So you have some, you know, mindfulness and you know, contemplate the energy of thought, the memory of thought. That's enough. Just memory of thought. That's good enough. That should be satisfied. Don't make a meditator, a meditating, I'm taking meditation course. After the meditation course, I become enlightened, I hope so. And I help my father, mother, sister, brother, you know. Otherwise, not so good. Don't make all this kind of, you know, again, you know, realistic conversation. You know? Maybe mindfulness is like, you are aware. You are aware. But you don't say, oh, this, that is so nice, how wonderful, blah, blah. No. You don't make that kind of conversation. No. You are aware. You, what's going on? You mindful. But not making, you know, sort of sharp conversation. Understand? Not sure. Clear? Yeah. For example, we walk on the road. I walk with him, walk on the road. I'm talking to him, how is one and how is this tulip, in this year, how many tulips, you know, growing. This thing, at the same time, I'm walking. You see? I'm walking. You know, I aware this road. I aware this road, you know. I aware where I'm going, I just aware, but, you know, my mind is sort of intense with conversation with him. Same time, I aware this road. This good example, you know. I aware this road. You understand? But I don't make conversation, this road is beautiful, ugly, or I don't make, you know. The conversation is about on the this one, isn't it? So that's good. Aware means you know, you comprehend. You're not ignorant. But not making, you understand, such a mundane conversation. I think that's enough. That enough?